think Noelle did her, whatchamacallit? Yeah.
Oh, good for her.
But she did, hi. You look so cute and cozy.
Oh, thank you.
Your cat is so chubby and it's the best thing ever.
It's so bad. She didn't used to be that fat. She's the one that hates me and I swear is plotting to like murder me.
Oh my gosh. She's such a donk. I love it.
Let's see if she'll react how strongly. Do you see how she just like, she's like,
oh, don't pet me.
Yeah, she hates me. She hates me. She used to love
that
me. She
is
hates
so me now. Funny. Hello, Eleanor. How's it going? Oh. I will be your teacher. I'm just kidding. Miss Debbie's here. And Michelle's here. Hi.
We give ourselves.
You look so Christmassy today, Anna.
What?
You're wearing red and you've got a nice little flannel. I wore my Christmas earrings today. Ooh,
green, red, green and red. These are green. You can't really tell, but they're green. And
I can see now that you said it.
I wore my bingo socks.
I wore my Bob Ross socks.
Love it. Okay. Eleanor.
Are you doing attendance too?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hashtag reflection school. You guys have to do your TikToks. Miss Olivia did hers, and it's the cutest thing in the entire world.
Everybody else's.
I'm in process, Olivia.
Oh, yay!
So, Olivia, this is for you. It's not underwear, okay? I made you a mask, and all the other girls have them already, but you weren't at the studio the night that I gave them out, and then we went into quarantine. So I have them here in a Ziploc bag, and you'll be here on Saturday. I'll have it over on the bench and just
grab one.
Okay, and then I've got two extras if anybody loses their sacred Santa mask. Alrighty, looks like we need Elena, and then we're good. Oh, were you gonna show it?
I was just kidding.
It was Instagram Live. Oh,
did you see it?
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Yeah, I just like the best thing to see all week.
Olivia's or Noelle?
Oh, I'm sorry, start with Olivia.
Oh, no, Noelle did hers.
Okay, I don't know.
And she did a hashtag on it. But
Olivia, have you seen Noelle's TikTok?
Mm-mm.
She was just trying to find it. We're trying to figure out where she posted, but maybe
she
Facebook
said,
Live.
She said she did hashtag reflection school dance, so she didn't tag us. But
okay. All right. Well, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Miss Anna's here because she does the rehearsal before us and after us, so it's just as easy. So we're going to start with a little check-in, okay? So just my regular question, how are you? And you all know that in the sisterhood, answering with fine is not acceptable. So even if you actually are fine, we'll want to have a little bit more description because you are artists. And with our movement, choreography, words, and thoughts, we have a lot to say because we're creative beings. So Olivia, start us off. How are you?
I'm good. I've had a very like lazy day today, so I've been feeling very like couch potato-y, and I like sometimes I like that, but today it's just been like a bad couch potato day. Like everyone's been gone from my house. It's only been like me and Cody here, so we've just been like, it's been so quiet in the house. So yeah. It's like, which is not, it's very odd for our family because we're very loud. But yeah, I'm good though. Okay.
Well, I'm glad we could kind of help cap off the day with a rehearsal because we'll be a little bit loud here on Zoom.
Mm-hmm.
And then ladies, I actually learned something on Tuesday. I'm doing great. I learn things every single day of my life. But Miss, I always say, everybody unmute your mics because I want lots of interaction. And Miss Anna was explaining to me that when we all do that, you kind of only hear, you hear all the house noise from that other person. I don't hear it here at the studio, but you guys do. So I apologize on Tuesday. I know people were typing in the chat box, we can't hear you, Miss Debbie. And I was like yelling louder. That wasn't the situation. So we'll kind of keep our mics muted. However, just be patient with each other because I still want to hear the same amount of banter. I'm going to ask the same amount of questions. We'll just have to wait while we do mics on and mics off, okay? So Eleanor, you are next. I'd like to hear how you are today.
I'm good. We've been decorating for Christmas, so that's been fun.
You get your tree up?
We're getting it this weekend.
Fun. Oh, you know, Miss Anna, how are you today? I see in the boxes, I skipped one.
I don't know who to look.
I know, we'll look over there. Look at me in there.
I'm okay. Okay, it's been a rough week and I don't really know why. So it's been a little, I've been like so tired all week, but I got my coffee today, so that made me happy.
It's the simple things in life.
The cookie you gave me yesterday was really good, by the way.
My what?
It made me happy. The cookie you gave me yesterday was very delicious.
Yay, I was gonna bring some. I meant to bring some to her today at work. And then I stopped at home and I was going
to
bring
shove
her
them through the screen. She's going to give them to all no. of you. Here's a cookie. Here, let me eat it for you. Hi, Elena. Okay. All righty. Michaela, how are you?
I'm good.
More, please.
I did just, words. I just did Marissa's hair. So that was fun.
Is she there?
Yes.
I want to see her face and her hair.
She doesn't want to come on camera because she looks funny.
Why does she look funny? Does she have foils in her hair?
Yes.
I do. Hi.
I love it.
That is awesome that I called it. I was just like making up something random because I thought there can't be anything funny. Well, Marissa, we're all very mad at you because I just found out like last week that you've been in Granite Falls for months. And being quarantined is not an excuse. You know where I live, so you better come on over. So, once you get the foils out.
I'm sorry.
I forgive you, but don't let it happen again.
All right,
thank you. Okay. Allison, how are you?
I'm okay.
More.
It's a mix.
Okay.
It's a mix.
Mix. Okay.
Yeah. Do you want? Okay,
tell me the hard part.
Just stuff has been happening in like our friend group. People leaving, joining, and good part. I don't know.
Okay, so there's not as much good stuff. It's mostly like challenging right now then. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad to see your face today. There's no drama in this group, so just relax with us. Cool. Elena, how are you today? And we already established a rule. The answer fine is not appropriate.
Wait, what did you say? Wine is not appropriate? Like, I'm drinking water here.
Okay, so we were kind of chatting and I had set some ground rules and then your face came up a little later. So F-I-N-E, if I say, how are you? No one gets to just say fine and get away with it.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
If you're good or fine, I'm glad, but I'd like to hear a little more from you.
Okay. Well, this week has been kind of stressful because we have another English essay due pretty soon. So I've been working on that a lot. And today I had a chemistry test like retake. Oh. And well, the test I got 84, which is not amazing for me, so I wanted to retake it. And the second, like, if you took the retake, the second score that you got would be the one that she put in, like, the grades. And I got a worse grade!
That happened.
I got an 80, which I guess is not bad for, like, I don't know. But it's kind of bad for me.
Yeah.
That made me very upset.
Oh. Well, I'm very sorry. If it was me getting an 80, I'd be throwing like a party. But if Zoe gets an 80, it's the same thing. Like the world is just coming to an end. And yeah. So I understand, but I'm sorry that happened, but you have a bright and hopeful future despite it all.
The test was on Monday, which I think was not smart for the teacher to do because everyone was like doing Thanksgiving stuff. They weren't going to study for the test. And like the class average was like 70. So not great.
So you're way above average.
Oh yeah, totally. But there are so many people who got like 50%. I'm like, teacher is not being smart.
Well, I'm glad you're a very hard worker, but don't stress yourself out with these things.
Yeah.
But yeah, we know you're a very smart woman. We know that. Okay, so we're gonna do another question, okay? So it could be a new habit that you have, but what do you do now that you did not do pre-COVID? So like 1 year ago or before March of this year. So we focused a lot, like what we don't get to do is like, oh, I can't go to McDonald's with all my friends. But there's actually, we've all started to develop other creative habits and we've made new friends that actually didn't exist a year ago. So we're kind of flipping the question around, okay? So what is something that you do now that you did not do pre-COVID, okay? And I'm gonna go backward this time. So Elena, you're on first.
I'm not sure. I've kind of done the same things, just more of the same things.
Do you wear masks like, well, school?
Oh, I don't. Well, no, wait, no, I do.
No.
I do wear a mask at school. My school, obeys the law.
Cedar Park closes down because of a report that came on my Zoom meeting. So you keep, at least you have a mask in your backpack and you didn't have one of those pre-COVID, right?
Yeah. During quarantine, I started embroidering, which
okay.
is grandma,
there
but
you go.
Very fun. Mm-hmm.
Creative people, awesome. Allison?
I honestly don't know. I think I've just been doing like the same stuff more often.
Okay.
Which,
okay.
I don't know.
So but, yeah. Here's something, I'm not trying to make you have my answer, but something that I was thinking about you this morning and yesterday. I see Allison more relaxed and at peace and more confident in the past. I think maybe it has something to do with the online classes. And you did share with me one time that you feel comfortable doing classes online and it's not as many hours at school. So that's one thing too.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, to me, you seem happy. I'm the one that goes around grumping about everything. Oh, that's cold, I can't take it anymore. But you always seem pretty happy, so I'm glad. How about Michaela?
I have no idea. Nothing's really changed except
that's
for the masks.
True, because you were doing school from home before and you guys have been able to kind of keep some of those great habits going consistently.
Yeah.
Sometimes you get to assist for Mr. Marco for 5 hours straight here at the studio with no other students here.
True. Yeah.
All right, so I can come back to you in a little bit if something does come into your mind, okay? So Eleanor, can you think of something you do now that you didn't do a year ago?
I'm working on sewing masks to donate for Girl Scouts. So me and my mom have been working on that like in our spare time. So that's been fun.
Awesome. Improving the sewing skills and blessing people at the same time. Miss Anna?
Okay, I have a good thing and a bad thing. I started running during COVID, so that's my good thing and my good habit. But my bad habit that I just started recently is I started ordering with DoorDash and it's not good and I need to delete the app off of my phone because I keep spending money and I keep just like, oh, click, click, click. Oh, look, there's food at my door. How nice. And it's terrible. So that's my bad thing.
But you learned how to do it. Maybe you didn't know how to do DoorDash before.
I guess that's true.
Learning new skills. See, that's my thing. I've learned how to do skills that I didn't think, I just didn't even give myself credit. I was, no, I don't know how to do Zoom. I can't do computers. It's too hard for me. I'm too old to learn, but I'm learning that every day. So. All right, Olivia, what's something you do now that you did not do before?
Well, it's not really a good thing. I spend way too much time watching TikTok videos, and it's all because of COVID that I even got on TikTok and started watching the videos. And it's really bad because once you go on there, you can't get off.
No, I know.
So,
I know.
Yeah, I spend way too much time watching videos. It's bad. Anna and I have had conversations about it. It's bad.
Well, I like your answer, which is not necessarily a good thing. And I didn't say that it had to be a good thing. I was just asking what was a change. But yeah, I confess I was never a social media person, but now it's like the only way I can connect with anybody. And you're right, whether it's Facebook, Instagram, or whatever, you can't get back off because then it keeps, well, then this person said this and you got to follow this conversation.
It locks you in.
You could win a prize. All right. Well, I am glad to see you guys. And I know we're talking a bit, but I just felt like that was important because we didn't have, it's been a little while since we've had just company time together. And we're not sure. I'm hoping that, would it be next week or 2 weeks from today that we'll be back at the studio?
Not next week. 2 weeks.
Okay. So we definitely have one more week with Zoom dance. But we're hoping that last week before the 19th, we'll be back here at the studio. So that would give us, like, we'll do some choreography tonight, obviously, because we all love to dance. But have faith that we'll be able to at least once run through our, performance choreography live before we go to Willis Tucker. But we'll see how that goes. But I do feel like for us as humans and dancers, the visiting part is about as important as the choreography at this point in life. So I kind of had put together some thoughts of just questions and get to know you type stuff. So
awesome. All righty.
We'll talk about details of costumes and hair and that kind of thing the week of the 19th. And so other than that, we're going to do some dance. We're going to start with kind of, it is a movement, but it's a little bit of a meditation. Okay. So I hope that you guys have been starting to get into the habit of journaling. And that's something that those of you that have been in dance company with me for several years, you know, I really harp on it every single year because you can use the notebook for writing down your choreography, even if it's just from dance perspective, but also just helps to get your thoughts, your emotions, everything out on paper so you can kind of sort it out. And if you do want to choreograph from that place, you've got some substance, okay? But so I'm always giving you prompts for either something you can write down in your journal or just something to think about or pray about or something to dance through. So I want you to envision where you want to go next. Okay. So we just had a question about, you know, we know what last year looked like. Now, is there a new habit we've picked up? Is there something new we're doing? I think that Olivia doesn't want to spend the rest of her life on TikTok videos. Like, well, that's something I'm doing to pass the time, but I think it's time now, we're getting to the end of the year, and it's time to think about New Year's resolution. And in a way, some people might say, well, the year 2020 was a write-off. I had resolutions last year and I didn't get to them. And I was actually, last night I did a Bible study, which was, I've never done an online Bible study before. And so I joined some of my friends in Los Angeles and we were doing a Bible study together. And they were, one of the thoughts was, which is what I shared, you might feel like 2020 was a write-off and we're just sitting here like waiting on it to be over. But there's things that God wants to do now in the middle of it. And so for us to be able to roll into the new year, you might grab last year's resolutions or just pick up whatever you felt like you dropped. Like once we hit the month of March of this past year, and I did the same thing as a business owner, I was just like, there's nothing I can do. I just give up. I'm just going to ride the wave until this is over with. And a couple months into it, I realized, that's not going to get me anywhere to have that attitude. I've got to shift and change and get some new goals and move forward. So I want you to think about, okay, we're only at the beginning of December, but we are headed into a new year. I don't think COVID's going to go away just because we hit New Year's Eve, but traditionally it's a good time for us to kind of reset our goals and our dreams. So kind of put something in your mind. We're going to listen to a piece of music, and you don't have to move yet. I just want you to listen to the music and picture yourself going to that place, like whatever idea you just had. Where do you want to go from here? And I'm going to challenge you to think bigger than you normally think, because God's dreams are bigger than our dreams. And I could think of the most extravagant thing in the world, and it still would be a very small thing for God. And I think sometimes he's smiling, going, come on, you guys, I want to make your dreams come true, but your dreams are so small that I forgot what it was. You know? And so the Lord wants to, he says, go big or go home sometimes, all right? So I'm gonna put on this, it's just an instrumental piece of music. We're just gonna listen. And you can close your eyes, you can lay on the floor, you can stare at the screen, however you want to do it. It's only 2 minutes, so you have 2 minutes to dream, okay? And I think, are you still?
Oh, yes.
We did that quick transition.
Bluetooth, connected.
She really popped up and said, where did they go? Wake up! So I'm going to lead you into like a physical body warm up, and then we're actually going to come back to that exercise in just a minute with some movement, but I want our bodies to be warmed up. So this is similar to what we did on Tuesday when it's kind of a freestyle, but I'm going to be calling on different parts of your body to let that lead the movement. Because sometimes, especially when we're just working on screen, it's easy to just copy what you're seeing on the screen, but you're not physically like feeling your own body warm up. So I want you to really identify like kind of dancing from the inside out. Okay. So go ahead and stand up to your feet anywhere you want to be in your space. All right, feet apart, standing up nice and tall, tummy pulled in, and breathe in, exhale out, with a plie, breathe in, wiggle your fingers, reach right and left, right and left, right and left. and slowly melting. This is the bar exercise that we did on Tuesday, and it's not necessarily so excruciating that we need the bar, but it's more support because I want us to get in the habit of, again, thinking about moving from your center. So if Tuesday I was describing, just always picture how your spine aligns, and even if you're just moving your arm, you want to feel like the arm starts at the spine rather than just like at the base of your shoulder. And even same with your legs. The legs should grow from, like, the spine and the pelvis are connected. So the leg is an extension of the pelvis. So it's not like you just pick up your leg, but you think about what your core is, okay? So it just starts parallel feet, and we're just doing a head circle, and then we add the shoulders, and then we're rising up on demi point, reaching right and left, and think about energy coming from the spine. There's like this explosion that happens, okay? When the arms open, when they drop, plie and stretch, okay? We're gonna work with parallel first, turned out first, parallel second, and turned out second. So we'll do the whole combination of head and shoulders, but the feet positions change, okay? So just a quick reminder what it was. It's just the head and neck. You drop to the front and the side and the back and the side and the front, and we lift, return front and a side, the back and a side and a front. You lift and then drop again and add the shoulders, okay? And then you go front, side, back, side, up and down, front, side, back, side, up and down. So when you return with the shoulders, that's when we go into the releve, right arm up, left arm up, find your center, explode on the plie. That's when you change the foot position, okay? And again, don't think too much about what's happening way up here, even though often I tell you to dance really big. You will dance big if you've got a lot of energy starting in the center, okay? So for this particular exercise, just think about what those big muscles in the middle, what's happening there, and the rest of the body just extends from there, okay? Front, side, back, side, front, lift, drop, front, side, back, side, front, lift. over shoulders, front, side, back, side, front, lift, drop, front, side, back, side, front, and lift, up on demi point, right arm up, left arm up, and explode, plie, turn out, and front, side, back, side, front, and lift, dropping front, side, back, side, front, lift with shoulders, front, side, back, side, front, lift, drop, side, back, side, front, lift, and releve, and arc, arm, explode, plie, front, side, back, side, front, lift, and drop, side, back, side, front, lift with shoulders, front, side, back, side, front, lift, and drop, side, back, side, front, lift, and releve, right arm up, up, explode, plie, turn out, head, side, back, side, front, lift, and front, side, back, side, front, lift with shoulders, side, back, side, front, lift, and front. And rise on demi point, turn out second, right arm up, up, explode, plie. Just kind of stay here, let's add Anthony arms and swinging, in and out. And even though the arms are loose, you're still kind of concentrating on what's connected to the pelvis. How does the spine align? The arms and the legs are just an extension of the spine and the pelvis. Okay, let's plie a little deeper and out of releve. Swinging side to side. Loosening up deep in the plie. Pushing through the foot. Push to the tippy toe. All right, come center. Find some control here. Giant letter X and heels off the floor. And again, thinking about the energy coming from your center. Going all the way out through the fingertips on 10 fingers. Out through the feet, just demi point. All 10 toes are pushing into the floor. You have control. There's energy coming from the top of your head. And lower the heels and plie in second. Again, nice strong core. You have control. Side stretch, side. 2, 3, 4, flat back. 2, 3, 4, over the chest. Down to your left. Center hold. 2, 3, 4, heels up. And the interval up. 2, 3, 4, other side, stretch. Flat back. Open up the chest. Down to the left. Center hold. Round it, heels up. Heels down, roll through your spine. Good, okay. Gonna pause. Hopefully, just in that quick movement, and again, if you always concentrate on like energy from the center, but then make sure it's going out through every little appendage, okay? All those, as far as you can reach when we make the giant letter X, or when I say your sphere, if you can reach out to the sphere, probably your whole body is awake, okay? Even the neck wakens up when I think about energy coming out the top of the head here. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the slow music that we did for the meditation, but we're going to add movement to it. This is very interesting. I want you to think about the concept or the element of floating, okay? If I'm like out on the water, if I'm in a boat, the boat doesn't feel heavy because it rises to the top. It's always floating on the top. Or you think about a helium balloon, it just kind of rises up into the air. Those balloons are not heavy. The problem with them is we got to pull them back down, but they're always rising, okay? So I was actually experimenting with this a little earlier. I was doing some movement experimentation, and I realized it was very easy for me to balance in ways that I don't normally balance if I thought about the concept of floating. Because especially girls who are in ballet, you get up on point and you're fighting so hard to, like, you know, straighten out those feet and stay on the box of the shoe. We're almost concentrating too much on the floor when it should be the opposite. The energy is like, you give the illusion of floating, but you also, if you feel like you're floating, you can really like find ways to balance. It was funny, I was even just in Studio B a few minutes ago, and all of a sudden I was balancing on one hip, and my legs were in the air, my arms were in the air, my head was in the air. I was like, if someone told me to do that movement, I was like, I wouldn't be able to do it. But it just sort of happened because I was experimenting with floating, okay? So here's the emotions behind it, okay? So earlier I said, where do you want to go? So where do you want to go in 2021? Pick it back up and continue on. When I say pick it back up, because I know that we all dropped quite a bit at the beginning of 2020. If it's still your goal to work on that, grab that thing and we're going to move forward. Let go and let God. Float on His grace. Let His burden be light and let Him carry you there. Okay? So we're called to, you know, take responsibility, pick ourselves up and go somewhere, but we can only go a certain direction or a certain amount of, we can only go so far in our own strength. But when we ask God to pick it up with us, we start to float on His grace, you're going to be amazed how far you just float on out there, okay? So it's kind of like a spiritual lesson, but it's also just an experiment in movement. So you can start standing up, or you can start laying on the floor even, and all of a sudden you start those contractions and you just start lifting off the floor. There's nothing magical about it. It's just a muscle thing that when you concentrate on that concept of float, okay? So find a place where you're really comfortable. Maybe if I said, oh, everybody's really heavy, just melt into a chair, melt onto the floor. And when the music starts, just start to think about floating your hands, your legs, your head, whatever comes to you. Does anybody feel like they could use more time? Okay, let's come on over and have a seat together. Okay, so y'all know me well enough that I don't even apologize anymore when I just go for the juggler. So what is happening? Did anybody feel anything, think anything, hear anything, experience anything?
You want me to go? I was thinking of clouds and like floating through the clouds. And like just the light, airy feeling that I feel like I haven't felt very recently. And so I was trying to just like let myself float through the clouds. And like I was grabbing clouds and then, and it was nice to like feel light and airy because I haven't felt that way. Mm. And so it was like nice just to allow my body to feel the way it doesn't.
Awesome. Yeah. Olivia, can you share?
It felt really like calm. Like I agree, like what Anna was saying, like it's just been like really rough, just like this whole year and then going back to Zoom, and it's just, ugh. So it was just like, it was really refreshing to just like, with the word being like float, it did really help you like visualize that, like, and just be like, ah. Like just relax. So it was nice. It was very refreshing and calming.
Yeah. Michaela?
It wasn't necessarily like a feeling or anything, but I've never done this before. But I used like the door frame of my parents' bedroom.
Okay. And
I don't know. As like a something to hold on to float. I don't know, it's kind of weird, but like
it was like a new experience with movement. It was almost like a prop. Awesome. Good for you. Okay. Allison.
Overall, it was just very calming. I don't really know how to put it to words, but it just felt like bad energy leaving, good energy coming in. It was pretty good.
Awesome. That's wonderful. Good. Eleanor.
It was calming and kind of just like let all my worries or like anything that I was thinking about, it just kind of went away.
Awesome. Wow, this is so good, you guys. I love this. How about Elena?
Well, near the beginning, I was kind of just laying on the floor, and I was like, it's kind of hard to get up, but, I don't know, I guess, like, if you feel heavy or, like, down or something, it's so easy to just stay there, but, like, once I, like, kind of was, like, moving my hands around, I was like, it was, like, easier to get up and, like, I don't know, just float around. So, yeah.
And I mean,
then you just have to get up and keep going.
Yeah.
Don't just lay there.
And if we think about the word float, almost it's separate. It's something separate. It's not us. It's like the power of God. And it's just, then you don't have to think about, oh, I feel so tired. I feel so heavy. I got to get myself off the floor. But it's like, no, I'm just going to wait for the float to happen. And then there's kind of all this natural lightness that sets in when we're not trying to overthink it too much. It's very interesting. So, yeah, and I mean, I'll be really vulnerable with you guys. For about, I don't know, 15 years, I've had this experience when things get really, I wouldn't even say stressful because I don't even know where it comes from, but I get pressure on my heart. And years ago, I went to the doctor. I was like, I think I'm going to have a heart attack. What's happening? And they put me on a treadmill and they were they all just freeze up. So. Michaela's gone.
I know sometimes it's like they say that we don't freeze.
Okay. Okay, I think they're still there. But so the doctor's test came back and they were like, your heart is so strong. You're healthier than a 20-year-old. There's nothing wrong with you. It's like, well, it's fine for you to say that, but no, I really do feel this. I would literally like walk around pushing my hand onto my heart like that because it hurts so bad. But I just started to identify that that was stress. And when things were really like, we had difficult clients or things were heavy with the dance studio, that would happen to me. And I had to learn to like separate myself from it. But it really started happening a lot once quarantine started. It's like, I've actually had it happen 4 times in the last 8 months since quarantine started. But even doing this exercise, I just felt like the Lord was like, this is this time that you've got when you don't have even have to go to work if you don't want to because the studio is closed. It's a gift from God. And it's almost like your ticket away from the responsibility and your ticket off of the hamster wheel. If you want to just take it, just start floating along. So it was interesting because I think that none of us wants to admit that we're people pleasers, but I will really stress myself out trying to make everybody happy and, you know, spin all the plates and that kind of thing. But the Lord's like, just you need the fear of God, but you don't need the fear of man. We don't have to please everybody. And there's some people you'll never please them anyway. So you might as well just shrug and go, whatever. they're not happy people. But so it was really, it blessed my heart to hear all you guys saying you were feeling lighter, you felt less stressed, like some fear was going away. And I think we all need that. And we've got this time when the whole globe is moving kind of slowly right now. And we don't want to fill the time with busyness. Just go ahead and float around. And the Lord will direct our path. When a hot air balloon goes up, it's kind of led by the wind and the heat, but hot air balloons don't stress about where they're going to go. It's just this peaceful thing of floating through the sky. So I think we'll treat the next month like that. Okay, let's just float right into December the 19th. And I believe we're going to perform, but if we don't perform, we'll just come to the studio and eat Oreos and party or something. But we're not going to stress about things. Okay, it's going to move in the grace of the Lord. Okay, now, do we feel like we had sufficient time to warm up our bodies? Because I want to go through the choreography and I know it's not going to be easy, but it was remarkable. Mr. Marco's students did all of their Christmas ballet choreography and it was really neat. Tuesday night, Noelle was his assistant, but she's not in the point class. So she just actually went out to the lobby and she was reading a book while the point class was doing their Christmas choreography on Zoom. And it was amazing to see how well it went actually. So let's give it a try. So looks like you've got plenty of space in there. Just use your imagination of where your other dancers are at. And let's start with our dance from the music, Watercolors. And I've given it many, many names, but the modern piece when we're gonna release our burdens and then dance it through. Don't overthink it. Don't be mad at me. Don't be mad at yourself. Just dance away. And if you mess it up, it's all good. More just for memory. 2, 3. Thank you. Anna just whispers, goes, that was hard. It wasn't hard for me because I was just sitting here watching, but it was actually phenomenal. I thought, oh my goodness, if we were in costumes and we planned a background or something, it's so interesting to see. And so on our screen, Anna is like the top middle person. She's the only one that was going the opposite direction because we get a mirror image over here. So it was just very interesting. The five people were going one direction, Anna was going the other way. But, and yes, of course, we all depend on each other to remember the next movement or know what, especially when we're in a canon. This is if you're following one person and they're like this big on the screen. But more than anything, this is just for our memory to kind of keep it fresh in the mind. But you guys did a phenomenal job. It just was like so interesting for me to look at too as a choreographer. But any questions about that one? Okay. So,
oh. There's just one part that I can never remember.
Okay, is it Allison's part? The sunset?
I think it's Eleanor's part.
Okay.
Eleanor, what's your part? Can you do it?
I think she choreographed it together with Allison.
I think, did Allison do the first part and Eleanor did the second part? I think it's just from here, there's like a wave.
Yeah, it's a wave. And then just around. Then soft chocolate.
Okay, so I'm gonna try this. There's a, Olivia told me about it. I got it to work the other day. We changed the setting so that they're going the same direction that we are. Yeah. So let's see if we can switch it. Cause that was tricky. Even when she showed it to you, you need to go back opposite. I think it's in camera.
I know. Press that. Yeah, press that one again.
Video.
Stop the video. Yeah, and then press the. Oh, I forgot it was touch screen. Sorry. And then press the little arrow. So move the mouse over. Yeah, the arrow. Video setting.
And
near my video. Oh, unclick it.
Okay. So if you don't mind, Eleanor, show your movement again. I just want to make sure that we fixed that issue. So you guys are still opposite. Oh, okay. Okay.
That's really
oh, because you can't see it in the camera.
No, I'm going. I'm just
okay, because you're watching the mirror, but okay, yeah. Okay. I feel there isn't really an easy way no matter what, because I've tried both versions, the mirror and the opposite. It's challenging both ways. Okay. All right, let's do Carol of the Bells, please. And thank you, Eleanor, for helping with that. Oh yeah, go get your fabric, everybody. Michelle has actually got something. You're so smart. Look at that. They're pulling out sweatshirts and everything. You guys are awesome. Okay, here we go. Two, three, four, five. Six, looking, leg swing, front, back, front and plie, and a front, back, front and plie, and a front, back, front quarter turn plie.
Thank you.
then exiting. Yeah, there's always a little joy. Yeah, yeah.
I can't remember who was in front of me.
That was also hard. You guys did it. Okay, awesome. So again, there's so many canons and places where one person goes after another one in this dance. It's really challenging. But again, for the most part, you're just kind of doing it for your memory to remember the order of it. We're a little late at the end, but also I think there's like a little delay in what you guys are hearing to what we're hearing. So no worries at all. But do you guys have any questions about it? Okay. Really, all my goal is this week is just to kind of keep the information from completely disappearing from our brains. And the week of the show, either we're here at the studio or if we're not, we'll just take an extended amount of time and really go through the details of talking through the choreography. And so we have time yet, but for the most part, we just want to retain the information. Now, the one that we know the least is the jazz dance. It is 6:30, so we've actually got a full hour. If you guys get tired, you don't want to go for a whole another hour on Zoom, I totally understand. But if there's any parts of the jazz dance that you're feeling nervous about, we have lots and lots of time to work it. So can I just put the music on and just kind of see what happens? And again, there's never any judgment. And if you forgot something, no worries at all. We'll just kind of, because sometimes, like for me, I'll be like, oh no, I don't remember anything about the dance. And then the music comes on and it's all right there. It's all in my mind, so. Okay, so three girls are on stage, three girls are off stage. Small groups,
Just Allison. Group two. Group three. Anna and Olivia, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. So, considering everything that we are facing, that was really phenomenal. And we haven't even done this choreography in almost 3 weeks now. So, excellent. So all the bits and pieces are there. Sometimes when I teach like this, I almost think of like a Jenga game or Legos. Like you have all the little pieces, you've just got to remember which piece goes on top of the next piece to complete the shape. But basically all the building blocks were there, okay? I don't expect perfect timing of the entrances and the exits, again, because we've got this delay with the music, but I believe everybody knows who's in their group, and I think you did it correctly. I actually don't think there was any issues in there. It was just a matter of like, remember, like what, like even when, once Anna started the slide together, cartwheel, it was like, oh, that's what we're on right now. So we just needed to have that little prompt, but. Let's go, yeah, that's the part I was gonna get up and let's go through that slowly. But other than that section, which kind of, it was kind of chunky because we haven't practiced it as much, can you think of other parts that were troublesome to you? Okay, so where we're at, we just pushed up off the floor and you're here, okay? It is the, no, it's the left foot that's pointed. She came up the floor.
Yes.
And you do the push, okay? You gotta step onto the left. It's a little tricky, again, because I think we're still mirroring each other, honestly. But step left and we go around and hug. Okay, now you're like fondue left, the right foot is pointed, and it's right arm out, down, left arm out, down. Come together with this, your right hand is on top, and then you just like, I always think of it like a, it's like a flower, it blossoms open, okay? Then you contract, and your right foot is flexed. The hands are still there, and then you're gonna push like that, okay? So it's like they're open, they go 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's a little chug step, you go right together, right, then take your pointer fingers, point left and right and double to the left. Left foot is free to do pas de bourrée and turn it and turn. I thought it was no turn, then turn, then turn, no turn.
Yes.
Okay.
No turn, turn, no turn.
Oh, there's an extra step. I'm sorry. Okay. It goes pas de bourrée, outside, turn, step. So now you're on your left foot. The right foot goes pas de bourrée, outside, turn, step. Okay. That's the part that's a little tricky. It's different than we're used to because we're always doing pas de bourrée, turn, pas de bourrée, turn. But in order to change sides, you got to get that extra stamp in there, okay? Yeah. Pas de bourrée, outside, turn, step. Pas de bourrée, outside, turn, step. You end up on your right foot and you're kind of like in this like stamp position, okay? And then... then it goes back to the beginning, like because we did the little sandwich, you go up, down, ba-dum, bum, bum, wrap, wrap, quarter, turn. Okay. It's so tricky to see everything, but okay. So the ending is the same as the beginning, okay? Left foot forward, up, down, shoulders, 1, 2, 3, wrap, wrap, quarter, turn, right, left, right. Okay. The arms, y'all kind of so you have to kind of like push into the sky and push the cloud down on yourself as you go, da da ba da, okay? Did that all, did it kind of make sense as you went through it? It kind of clicked your memory? Okay. And I really didn't see any problems in the choreography. It's just, like I said, we've been 3 weeks without going through it. But do you want to talk through that section again with no music or should we just throw it in? To the dance now. Okay, let's dance. Okay, thank you, Michaela. Love your big smile. Okay, three girls on stage, three girls off stage. 2, 3, hit. Chasse, axel. Ball change. Outside turn, jazz walk left. Camel,
Ball change, ball change. Plie, grow, plie, turn. Hips, two, three, four. Jazz arms. Right chasse, left chasse. Back, 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 hug. Step right. Turn, hips, jazz arms, open and chasse, chasse, back, back, awesome play, step right, group two is joining you, you're all going to go together, chasse, axel, to the left, jazz walk, illusion, camel, ball change, ball change. One, two, three, four, five. Plie, grow, plie, turn. Hip, jazz arm. Chasse, chasse. Back, back, awesome play. Step right. Slide, cartwheel. Circle, six, five, four, three, two, one, you're there, and slide, slide, cartwheel, circle, up, down, back bottom off, plie, jazz walk to the corner, right, left, side, back, push to stand, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. In, out, chug, step, point, point, double point. Pas de bout, ray, turn it and step. Pas de bout, ray, turn it and step. Up, down, shoulder, shoulder, wrap, wrap. Cartwheel, circle, five, six, you are already there. Slide, slide, cartwheel, circle, six, five, four, three, two, one. Woo! Yep. Jazz walk to the corner and batma. Side, back. First group, second group, third group. We're up and Allison. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Group two. Group three. Just Anna and Olivia. Four, three, two, one.
Oh, oh.
Okay. Yeah. So the ending, it's a little hard to.
So what happens when I look? You're the same as them, but you're not the same as the mirror.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm mirroring myself.
One, two, three, four. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So the left elbow's up and the right elbow, right arm is down. It's a fist. One, two, switch it. Three, four. On five, bring the right hand behind your head, like you're puffing your hair. And left hand down. Yeah, she's popping the hip back there because I'm sitting on the floor. But okay. It is tricky. It's really quick to get that one, two, three, four, five in there. But I think once we're together in the same room and we don't have that little half second delay, it'll all come together. So I'm hoping that we can wear those little red masks along with the Santa jackets on this. Is that okay with everybody? Yeah. Okay. It's funny. It's like masking is now normal. If you would have told me 6 months ago that all my dancers had to wear a mask, I go, no, I want to see their faces. And now it just feels normal and I think it'll be cute. So, okay. Oh, there goes Olivia's cat.
Oh, is that Chubbs?
I don't know.
I apologize. I didn't do the dance. She went up on this like little ledge and knocked off a snow globe.
Oh.
So I'm cleaning up snow globe and glass. So.
Oh.
I'm sorry. Right now.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. know cats are the same as dogs, but yet Len has had to learn to take Asher just out of the house if I'm doing a Zoom class at home, because he sees me waving my arms and he thinks it's a game. So I don't, the cat might have gotten excited. Sorry that happened. Okay. I kind of feel like okay, so I'm gonna ask your permission, guys. So we can stay on here and just like chat because we love each other, or we can finish early because I feel like we've accomplished what we can accomplish through Zoom classroom, or we can finish, or we can keep dancing, sorry. So any preferences? So you wouldn't cry if we finished early? Because we can play a game too. Yeah. Olivia's sweeping glass over there.
I had a question about the recital.
Okay.
So you were saying like we should wear our masks or the red masks for this dance, the jazz one. I think those are really cute. But are all of our other dances, like, are we gonna wear masks for those?
I think there will be some things that we're gonna decide at the very last minute, honestly. At this point, I'm saying, no, we're not required to mask because it's outdoors. It was just a funny thing. I just got into a creative mood that day and I cut up that Santa jacket and I was happy with the way the masks came out. So I was like, oh, let's wear them for something.
Okay.
So for kind of more of a fashion statement, people go, oh, that's so cute. They found a way to get the masks to match their costumes. But do you guys know what you're wearing for ballet? Has there been that discussion yet?
Nope. No.
So if at the last minute we decide, yes, we can do the outdoor performance, but we need masks, I can either provide matching masks for everybody, or I really don't know. So it's a really good question, but we will make that decision on something like the 16th of December.
Okay.
So, okay. I like Michaela's agreement over there. Okay. Alrighty. Well, thank you very much. I appreciate you guys. I love dancing with you at the studio and I love dancing with you in Zoom because any way we can do it is good. Miss Anna is wonderful. I'm so glad she's here. All right. And I just want to say thank you so much for being really good sports about the Secret Santa. That was the funniest thing I've seen in a long time on Tuesday. I loved hearing it was Olivia with her cat with a costume on, and there was just so much creativity. So keep thinking about creative ways to show something on the Zoom screen on Tuesday. I really love it a lot, and I appreciate your sportsmanship with that. All righty. Okay, well, we're done for today. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Bye.